everyone, Mirageflay here, bringing you another game of Company of Heroes 2. This time it'll be against, well, I'm probably going to mispronounce the name, Iridescent Prime versus RTN Talisman, and this is a game from the EU-ESL Gold 4 Cup. Anyways, Prime will be our British Forces player, Talisman will be our Ober Commando West player. As for commanders, Prime has Commando Regiment, Vanguard Operations, and Tactical Support Regiment. Meanwhile, Talisman has Scavenge Doctrine, Luftwaffe Ground Forces Doctrine, and Breakthrough Doctrine. For builds, we got one Volk squad coming out for Talisman and a Kubo wagon also arriving, followed up by another Tommy squad for our British Forces player. May you see a Vickers coming out after, because controlling the church in the center is particularly important. There is a cutoff towards the munitions on the left-hand side, and it also opens access to the right-hand side. But anyways, our Tommies looks like they're moving on to the cutoff into the center before moving on to munitions. Well, our first Tommy squad is capturing the point here before they move straight onto the field. Volk's going to follow up on the capture of the Sturm Pioneers, moving on to the tactical point here. Well, we got Sturms wiring off an area. I guess just to deny. Well, our Kubo wagon's now on the field, beginning the capture in center tactical point. Well, we got another Tommy squad coming out for Prime. We'll be moving up forward. Tommies will be particularly difficult to dislodge for our Commando West player in the early game until he gets those flame grenades or some sort of indirect fire. Tommies are very strong in buildings. Going to have our first minor shootout here. Volks immediately pull back. Another Volk squad coming out for Talisman. They're going to be moving up toward the field. When our infantry section moves, I'll let it get better lines of sight. Well, actually worse since they're not in the church anymore, but they will duck back into church now. We'll keep catching glimpse of this Volk squad. And one time he's slowly going to pick away at the enemy. Kicks up a few leaves with that shot. Well, Tommy squad move on to the right-hand side. However, the Kubo is here, can immediately begin harassing the cutoff. Will make it difficult for a British Forces player to respond. We do have a Vickers now coming out for Prime. Will allow him to control the center and the infantry a bit better. But so far, still no major engagements. Everyone's just taking their points. Alright, Sturm Pioneers are moving out. Looks like they're going to hop into this barn and going to catch the Tommies out of position. Causing significant damage, immediately attack on member, forcing Tommies to pull back. Not sure if he should have pulled back, could maybe just micro back a little bit more, but now Sturm Pioneers are going to begin decapturing the munition point. Well, both Volk squads are going to focus on this Tommy squad. Even with two Volk squads, it will take some time, and Tommies do bail out the building for now. Avoid taking that extra damage. Kubo wagon is here. Tommies are pushing it back. Bit of an RNG fight when you're using rifles against the Kubo, but when you do hit it with Tommy rifles, it hurts. Vickers is in the house. Well, church, but should probably rotate, taking considerable amount of damage since the crew is a lot easier to hit than the Tommies themselves. Now the Vickers should begin to open fire. It may suppress this Volk squad. Does suppress them, takes out two members of the squad, forces them off. Vickers can now begin whittling the squad down the house with the support of the Tommy squad. Meanwhile, Tommies have managed to recapture their cutoff. Our Kubo wagons move in, may try to push the squad, but it looks like it can't get it that close. Will now be pulling back instead. Will the Kubo wagon get out of there? Looks like it will barely manage to escape. However, Volksgrenadiers are moving into cover. Tommies need to jump into cover. Volksgrenadiers are probably going to win this. The Tommy squad was wounded. Well, the Vickers was forced out of the church. However, Tommies once again get back in. Sturm Pioneers can move up to the swan and cause significant damage, though I'm not exactly sure if they would get cover, since they are pretty close to the building. Tommies need to begin exchanging fire with the Sturm Pioneers, however. Sturm Pioneers are a lot more lethal than these Volks at range. You can see the ripping through the squad's health in the garrison. Once again, the British cutoff has been harassed. And Kubo barely on a bit of health, but still continuing to capturing the victory point. British Forces player needs to get back onto the point here. Now we have a mine going down, could be lethal. Oh, the British Forces player jumps out on this side. Will mean an instant wipe, since everyone is particularly clumped. Gonna be a bit of time for Prime to move out. He's got to heal up all his squads. Thankfully, his healing's pretty efficient. But does force him to keep his units together. Enemy causing trouble, trying to take one of our and the AC has been unlocked, so we'll probably be seeing that shortly. Our Volk squads are on the cutoff once again, forcing off our British player. His army is now moving back out of the base with an addition of the sapper squad. So far, British forces player has been fighting to hold his territory. But he needs to get. But Cutoff has been constantly harassed, and meanwhile, the Oberkommando West player has. Cutoff has been fine the entire game, and now he's setting up the battle group headquarters. Or is relatively forward. We'll give him that extra healing, as well as access to indirect fire, 251 flak track, and the infrared half track. But nothing really that Prime has to worry about. He won't be forced to really build AT unless the 251 arrives. The Stern Pioneers have fixed up the Kubo wagon. Could be a very bad engagement for these Tommies. They're caught out of position by these Stern Pioneers. Unfortunately, for the Stern Pioneers, not particularly good lanes of sight due to these vineyards. I think that's how you pronounce it. Anyways, Kubo's focusing on the Tommies, causing quite a bit of damage. Stern Pioneers are actually going back around. Both field points are in control of Oberkommando West Planner. You can see he has a massive lead in terms of fuel. British Force player needs to make a big push to recapture his territory. He needs to get back into this game. However, his AEC is coming out. Could allow him some good pushing power. Not really much anti-tank currently for Oberkommando West player. One we're catching, but currently we have no Panzer Shreks available, though they are available for purchase. Gonna have another building shove. Vickers is gonna focus on the Volk squad here, slowly going to whittle away their health. Stern Pioneers. Well, they're probably gonna lose this engagement. Tommies are focused on them for more. Or the Kubo is gonna be forced back. Both squads could try to focus on the Kubo, but Kubo's just gonna run over to Vineyards and get out of there the other way. Infantry, however, will be allowed to recapture that. However, the AEC does reveal itself on the point. May try to pursue the Kubo. But he really needs to make some good use with this AC. He needs to begin pushing. Look up, we have flame grenade go into the church. It looks like our mine was actually detonated by that flame grenade. Gotta be careful where you toss those grenades. Our AC is here. We'll begin forcing away his Vokes. Not sure why he's cutting. He's probably getting a bit closer. He really needs to make a good play with this AC to retake territory. However, he shouldn't be that cautious with it at the moment. Yes, they're mines, but he does have the ability to smoke out. Munition point has been recaptured, however the cutoff is still not available. More sappers are arriving onto the field. AEC now moving up. Kubo is here. AEC can pick away at these Volks, and these Volks are very bunched up. Takes a massive hit there, three models down. He could probably run them down the Shrek squad, he needs to keep moving. Gets one more model. He should keep chasing with this. Just go around. He does miss his next shot. Alright, I'm not sure why he stalled. He should have probably kept moving forward. His AC could have probably finished that Volk squad off. Bit of bad decision making here. However, Ketchup now reveals itself, forcing the AEC off. Meanwhile, Tommy's now engaging the units in the church. Gonna be a bit of a slow shootout. However, Tommy's do force the Volks out. Now, Tommy's will be able to reclaim the church. MG-34 is in the building. I'm pretty sure the Tommies will win this, however. MG-34, not particularly known for its good damage output. Sappers do manage to capture the point here, and furthermore, we have Tommies capturing. Right-hand mat has turned to the side of our allies. However, Stern Pioneers are moving out. Could be a bad engagement, however, the Sappers focus on the Stern Pioneers. They're going to run across the open. Stern Pioneers decide to not charge in, and decide to shoot at mid-range. AEC is here. Gets a good shot on that Raketen Werfer. Could probably finish up. Can probably wipe the Raketen if he continues to push forward. I think he's being a bit too cautious with the AEC. However, he does take out that Raketen Werfer. We have a sniper now on the field for a British player. Our Schwer has gone up for Oberkommando West player. Will guard the cutoff. Sappers are pinned down. Tommy's slowly trying to get those units out of the building. AEC trying to destroy the Raketen Werfer. One more shot will kill it. Can probably take 2 to 3 more Shrek hits. Not sure if he needs to back off now. Or won't be able to finish that Raketen and actually smoke out. Not sure why he didn't decide to finish that. Maybe a bit cautious, but I think he's still playing too cautious with this AEC. Sniper is on the field. MG-34 has been forced out of build. A retreat point has been established here. Could maybe see a mortar pit go down for a British player. Or control the center of the map and bomb anyone on units out of the buildings. There is no currently indirect fire for our Talisman. Meanwhile, our coup looks like the fight up north has turned in favor of Axis player. Both squads forced off. Kubo will begin capturing. Gurren Binders should probably get to capturing as well. Shouldn't be left idle. Sniper reveals themselves. Takes out a Volk model. Sniper actually takes quite a bit of damage. I'm not sure if he should have retreated there, rather than could probably just backpedal. Vickers actually runs into a mine. Should probably just put his Vickers in the church. It will give him much extra range since his Vickers is now vet 1. Might see a flame grenade going off. Flame grenade going off. Prime needs to micro. Another flame grenade going to go off into the building. AEC is back in action though. Should probably start firing on these folks and harass. British forces will be forced out of this area. And this AEC, I'll keep saying it's not being aggressive enough. If not being used to fight, he should at least use it to retake the right hand side of the map. Sniper is here. Can begin picking away at these Volksgrenadiers. Immediately causes one member to explode. Sniper going to continue to pick away at these Volks. AC is now moving on to the right hand side. And it does have good ability to scout. It does have 50 sight like other scout units. MG-34 is getting sniped by the sniper. Tommies may get suppressed because they are in angle with the MG-34. MG-34 is actually lowing incendiary, and I think we just lost our Kubo wagon. I heard something explode. Yep, Kubo did go down. Certain pioneers were forced off. However, in terms of VP or British forces players, not looking that good. 348 versus 490. He is currently going to be triple capped at this once the Volks finish their capture here. I should probably stop calling him a British forces player. His name is Prime, but I just feel... you know, I should just call him that. Anyways, Talisman bails all his Volks as the sniper continues to take shots at them. Can reinforce relatively quickly at the battlegroup headquarters. Currently no units have come out from either the Schwer or the battlegroup headquarters. No infantry support guns. But we did have a Panzer IV now immediately queued up. That will be on the way. Rakettin reveals itself. We could lose the AEC here, however it is popping smoke. We'll get out of there. Needs repairs from the sappers. Could probably bail out the sappers and start repairing this AEC. Company command post is being established. We'll be online shortly. Meanwhile, our sappers are moving on to the right-hand side. We'll capture that. Work to construct a new company command post is finished. MG-34 will once again take this building. Sniper going to continue to take shots, and if we didn't know, Talisman has locked in the Luftwaffe, so we will have Axis Pseudos Fallschirmjäger, her Valiant Assault, and the Airborne Assault. I'm not going to say the flak emplacement, because no one builds that thing, even though there are tank traps available. Enemy causing trouble. Looks like we have air resupply operation going off. Now, I'll give Prime a bit... considerable more firepower in the form of an anti-tank gun and a Vickers. Stern Pioneers have forced off the sappers. AC can move into the respond, however. Should probably get right on that. Flame grenade goes off, forcing away the Vickers in the church again. Church has taken beating, but hasn't lost that much health. Volks will be forced back. Panzer IV will reveal itself. Will engage these Tommies. And takes out a member. Not going to be able to pursue, however, as he did have to reverse around that hedge. I may all want, again, Prime's playing pretty defensively. He's letting his enemy set the pace of the game, essentially. He's not been able to really push out in toward the center of the map, mainly due to the battlegroup headquarters. However, he's constantly been letting units harass his fuel on the right-hand side, and his AC, I keep saying it, hasn't really done much. Vickers will be moving into church. Panzer IV or will be fired on. AEC and 6-pounder landing. Nice hit on that tank. Crit shot will not be fired from the sniper and attempt to cripple the tank's main gun. AEC is once again being forced back. You should probably just, rather than repairing at the moment, just move it to force away these Sturm Pioneers. Vickers in the house will slowly whittle away at the Vokes once again. We do have a mine set here. Could be a little dangerous for that six-pounder shot scatters onto that. Tommy's moving on to the right-hand side once again. British forces have been in triple cap, 283 versus 483, and they're ticking down. Vickers focusing on the Vokes who are in the open. Won't be able to get their flame grenades off, forced back. MG-34 here is going to begin opening fire. And our Vogue Skull will likely begin moving on to the munitions here. It is open for the taking. Six pounder is a little bit exposed here. However, we do have Tommies moving around. Could try to get into this building and start trying to flush out that 34. Instead, both squads are likely going to respond to these Vogue's Grenadiers. Right hand side will be recaptured by sappers and Tommies. Vogue's Grenadiers slowly being forced off. Sniper continue to pick off members. MG-34 got a quick glancing shot on that sniper. Sniper's almost vet 2 with 14 kills. Slowly whittling away all these units in the center. I think a mortar pit would, however, be a good idea at this point. Prime does have the manpower for it. We'll allow him to pretty much bombard this entire area, maybe even hit Battle Group headquarters. There is no indirect fire for Ober Commander West player. He does need something to break through. Then the mortar pit could be a good start to start. Yeah, that's redundant. But the mortar pit could be used for the start. Are making his push. You know, Tommy's trying to engage these folks in the house. We'll eventually flush them out. AEC is also here. Need to be a little careful, the sniper. He is in the open and is on less than half health. You know, we have engagement here. Volks engaging the Tommy's. Tommy should be able to win this at long range. Now, do we have anything coming out for Prime? He has quite a bit of manpower he's not spending on it. He could also buy himself a Chroma at this moment. Panzer IV did expose itself and got shot out for it. Lost a bit of health there. Tommy's moving on to the left. MVP will begin capturing that. Hope. Central will be captured by these sappers as well. Folks will move into the house, however, there is a Vickers guarding it. Vickers will slowly pick away at these Volks. However, there is sniper support. Not sure what Talisman is saving for. He does have quite a bit of fuel. Also, quite a bit of manpower. Look at that range on that Vickers from his Vet 1, firing all the way over there. And there's no way for the MG-34 to respond. Looks like Panzer IV was repaired by these Stern Pioneers. We'll begin moving on to the front. We did have another Stern Pioneers. Another Stern Pioneer squad was spawned, and Fallschirmjäger were spawned right behind the sniper and immediately take him out. Sniper is a bit exposed for too long, staying there for a considerable amount of time. Most Stern Pioneers are going to move on to the right-hand side, begin capturing. Tommies are going to move on to the victory points. There is a Volk squad guarding, however. Fallschirmjäger causing a bit of issues, but this Vickers should probably be able to shoot them out eventually. Panzer IV will begin trying to attempt to level the church. Six pounder is here to guard though. Immediately lands a hit, and we do have a Cromwell now on the field for a British forces player. Needs to get that to the front and moving. Well, look, we also have a command Bren. Needs to move that a bit closer to the front, however. Recon is coming down. Command vehicle does provide some nice buff, and well, the universal carrier, if you add it to a command vehicle, you don't really lose much. It's not particularly mobile to begin with. If any, you're probably not going to be using it for fighting at this stage in the game. Alright, recon plane will be in a bit of trouble here. Flak guns are opening up. First plane does go down and lands right on tactical point. Thankfully, no one's standing there. Prime needs to do something with his vehicles. He shouldn't be leaving the Mito. He needs to begin making a push with them. Could maybe attempt start making a push on the Schwer Panzer headquarters, force units to move away from the center and begin moving there. He also attempted to siege the Schwer with his anti-tank guns. Vickers is refacing. Volks trying to get a flame grenade in. They will manage to toss that grenade. Vickers will bail out of the house. Our AC is here. Cromwell is also here to support. Fallschirmjäger have jumped into the building. Cause significant damage on these Tommies at this range. Tommy said begin an attack, man. I think they were trying to chase the Vokes, Howard. He may lose it if he doesn't fall in back. Prime's not paying attention. He's going to lose his vet to Tommy's. Really should have microed there. Meanwhile, have an engagement here. Vokes going to throw a flame grenade at these Tommy's. Tommy said vet 3 and get their scope Lee Enfield. Howard, they're at very low health, will be forced to pull back. Going to need to see a vehicle respond. Panzer 4 will begin moving up. We have another sniper also up for our British Forces player. Cromwell will engage. Rakettenhauer is here to protect the Panzer 4. Cromwell lands no hits. Our 6 pounder will get a shot in. Cromwell's going to need some repairs. Universal Carrier could probably move up a bit further forward to give the buff. 6 pounder and machine gunner out of it, as well as the AEC. Vickers setting up. Tommy's will begin moving on to the point on the left-hand side. Victory points are still ticking away. 217 to 444. Another recon plane has been called in by the Universal Carrier. We'll give Prime some more information. However, the plane will get shot down and crashes right near the battle group headquarters. Not sure if we lost anyone. And there goes the barrel. Yeah, you see, engaging 2 Volks Grenadiers. We'll be popping smoke. Sniper a little bit exposed here. Cromwell should probably open fire. However, the smoke has blocked off its line of sight. Looks like the Volks are barely going to get away. However, it could be dangerous to crossing into the open. Vickers is not firing, however. Cromwell should probably move in for the crush here. The wall is blocking the shots. Wall is taken out. Map control still not looking good for a British player. Hasn't been able to actually push this line. He's been constantly focusing his attention on the center. Ober Commander West player has been constantly sending news to harass his right-hand side. Well, meanwhile, Prime hasn't really done anything to try and take the left-hand side. And it looks like we're going to have Panther now coming on the field. That's going to be big problems for Prime. Yes, he does have 2 anti-tank guns, but his vehicles are going to be in for a bit of an issue. Low in the combat now with both sides. Let's repair the units and reinforce. I still think a mortar pit would be a good idea. At least behind the church, or a little bit further, so we can begin bombing Panzer headquarters. He's probably spotted it, thanks to his spotting planes from the Universal Carrier. We'll just switch to Prime's view. Yeah, I'm not sure if he actually got a glimpse of the battle group headquarters or not. Our Fauchemaker are landing. Airborne assault has been used. Units are pinned. Our AEC and Cromwell are here to guard. This is going to be a very bad landing. Pretty sure that's even worse than a night landing. It's Crete all over again. You know, 6 pounder will begin firing. Gets a nice shot on that Panzer 4. And you can see the 6 pounder is firing considerably quickly with that Universal Carrier or Command Vehicle buff. Panzer 4 is going to need some repairs here. And our sappers will begin moving on to the left-hand side of the map, capture the victory points. Currently, our British Forces player holds 2 of the victory points. His forces are now moving up. Once again, the recon plane is shot down. These Vos Grenadiers are going to be forced back by these Tommies. Our Panther is here to provide some support. Pinto is also on the way. Vickers is set up and will begin opening up. Suppressing these Volks. Not sure why the Tommies are not firing. Panther is moving up, however. Tommies will begin moving away. And now we have triple cap on our Ober Commander West player. Our sapper is now on the left-hand side. We'll begin capturing that victory point. However, Volks are moving in to capture Or that victory point, and I misspelled that. That's not a victory point, that's a tactical point. Cromwell should probably move in to respond. It's just one Volk squad, nothing he really needs to worry about. There is a Panzer IV here, however. Prime could make a push. He does have artillery cover now available. Kind of regard as one of the most powerful and overpowered strikes in the game currently, because you pretty much shut down your opponent's infantry and armor. And it doesn't really take that long to come down. 4 seconds before its first shell starts to land. And it also tracks its targets. AEC will force away these Fallschirmjäger. They may try to get Faust off, but this could be pretty dangerous. Panther misses its first shot. AEC will begin rotating back, though. How Panther could pursue. Do we have an anti-tank gun? We do have an anti-tank gun available, but it needs to reface. Cromwell, once again, not... You should probably do something with it. Hasn't really done much. It has 4 kills, soon to be vet 1, but could probably move it up. And looks like he has locked in the hammer tactics, giving him track vehicle. We need units to capture these VPs. Looks like 5-man squads have been also researched for Prime. Looks like we're finally going to see our first piece of indirect fire this game. It'll be coming out for our Order Commander West player in the form of the infantry support gun. Prime needs to repair his AEC. Sniper will begin taking shots at this Panther. Unfortunately, he deflects off. You know, Tommy's going to engage these Sternbinders. Should probably jump into the building. Get some cover. Panzer IV now moving up. AT gun is in wait. Panzer IV looks like it's trying to demolish the church. This has some mines placed down here. Church will go down the one more shot. Definitely not be a building anyone wants to be. And now I'm not sure why he's not going to finish off the church. He just needs one more shot to kill the church, or he may just be hoping that Prime jumps in it so he can finish off whatever squad decides to jump in. Mine does detonate. Detonated by the Cromwell, not by the Sturms. Majority of the Sturms will be forced to pull back. AT gun has been decrewed by the Panzer IV. Not a Vickers firing at the Panzer IV, but it's not really doing much. All the shots are missing the Cromwell. Cromwell will begin falling back.
Extra firepower is now available for units.
Six Pounder needs to open fire. We'll get one nice shot on that Panther. Recon plane is back. We'll begin scouting the area. So far, lots of action in the center, but not much action on the sideline. And those are kind of the important parts of the map. I know the center is particularly important in the early game, but Prime could probably make a big push on one of the sides. I think his artillery cover was used. I'm not exactly sure where that was, but it was used. Tommy's engaging these Volksgrenadiers. Currently no weapon upgrades for our Tommies. Panther trying to run the squad over. We'll force them to pull back. Sniper is here, however. We'll slowly begin to pick away members. AC is relocating. Not sure if he's trying to take on the Panther and get some rear shots. Tommy's squad almost went down there. Down to one man. We'll begin falling back. I'm not sure how they were killed. Well, it may have been machine gun fire because the Panther was tempted to crush them. Tommy's are here, can begin moving up to the point. However, we do have a Vogue squad in the house. Universal Carrier is slowly trotting along. Should probably bring the Cromwell here as long with the AEC and begin smoking out this infantry from the building. Not sure what Prime was doing with his command vehicle, he just kind of tossed it away. Was it for population cap? He just kind of threw it forward and it died horribly. Not what you call a good scouting vehicle when you have the AEC standing by.
Damned enemies trying to take a point from us.
Cromwell is here, can move up. Can also take shots at his building without taking return fire if he parks it around here. Tanks do outrange Panzer Schrecks. Our Panzer IV is moving down to the center. AT gun is setting up. We'll begin to open fire. Or at least set up. Separate under fire from Volks Grenadiers. Our AEC is here. We'll begin slowly to force away that squad. Panther rolling up, however. AC needs to get out of there. AC will be forced to pull back. Gonna need some repairs. We have another Luftwaffe air strike coming in. Fallschirmjäger are gonna be dropped off. Second squad probably won't suffer the same fate as the first one. There's only one Cromwell guarding. And they don't lose over half the squad from that shot, however, they're immediately forced to pull back. At very low health. Prime has a considerable amount of army. He should probably, once again, I'll keep saying, he needs to push somewhere. He's been playing way too defensively this game. He's been piecemealing his forces out. He hasn't made any attempt to make one big push. AC will move up and begin engaging this Volkswagen. Takes out the wall. Removing their cover. Cromo is turning its turret. Will not get a shot off, however. Time's trying to take the victory point here. Don't think you're going to get covered at this close range. Our mill bombs was research. In return, however, Panzer Shrek hits and the flame grenade does go off. These Tommy's going to need to pull back. His prime micro ring. He's going to lose his Tommy squad if he doesn't pull it back. Could even lose it on retreat. It's at very low health. Will barely make it behind his barn, however. Once again, Panther is being forced away by a 6-pounder. Panzer 4 is moving on to the left-hand side. Sniper could get this Volksgranger squad, and that is a wipe. Something that Prime needs. Now he needs to make a push. He needs to consolidate his army, heal it all up, and try to make a push on the Oberkommando West position, or at least take the victory points. 75 points versus 379. Prime's got a to go. If he does make a push. Looks like we lost the Vickers here as well. Not sure if it's going to be recruit. Could lose the Cromwell here. Rakettin is facing. And we do lose that Cromwell. A little bit overextended. 6-pounders are attempting to take out the Panzer IV. However, we do lose one of the anti-tank guns. Second anti-tank gun's been blocked off by the smoke from the destroyed Cromwell. AC continuing to take shots from that Rakettenwerfer. Rakettenwerfer now Veteran C2. AC now Veteran C3. Gonna need some repairs. Strange little vehicles. Pretty much one of the only light vehicles that get survivability boosts. And it's not in terms of health. Health like the austere vehicles with their armored skirts where they get a health or armor bonus. This thing gets received accuracy bonuses. Not something you generally see. However, Vet 3 AC does go down from the Panther. Is moving in. Going to try to attempt to blitz out. However, we may lose it. 6-pounder is facing. Comet could land a good shot here. That shot doesn't go off, however. However, that 6-pounder shot does take out the Panther. However, it's abandoned. Something needs to follow up and knock it out. 6-pounder could probably move up and take out that Panther. Not sure if Prime sees it. Prime should be able to spot this. However, his shot will bounce off, so we won't be able to get that Panther. That's a big loss there due to RNG. Comet is here. We'll begin opening up on these Volks. Our Volk squad on the flank will get another Shrek shot off, or should be able to. Will bounce off the front of that Comet. Vickers was recruited, however, we'll be forced to pull back to base. We actually have Vet 3 Fallschirmjäger in the building. Panzer 4 is also moving up. Could wipe out this Vickers. Vickers down to one man, needs to pull back. Meanwhile, Comet's going to begin moving up. Push of infantry, however, the Panzer 4 is going to force them all off. Comet's going to need some repairs here. Less than half health. Our Prime is focusing on the VPs. He needs to get those. 21 points and ticking down versus 379. Panzer 4 is moving to the center as well. Sniper at Vet 2. At low health. Does manage to pick away one member of the Fallschirmjäger. The ISG man's landed a nice shot there. Comet is on the flank. Does get a nice shot off on that Panzer 4. That's also a 6-pounder. Sniper will be forced to pull back. 6-pounder going to get another shot off. Could lose the Panzer IV here. Panzer IV has gone down. Our Comet needs to get out there. Panther may try to chase him. And we don't have war speed enabled on this Comet. Comet's near death and has lost its main gun. Gonna need some repairs. However, there's not really much Prime can do. He's constantly losing these victory points. Does have a Vickers here, however, to protect the right-hand side. Center has been also neutraled. However, he's nothing guarding the center at the moment. There are Fallschirmjäger moving in and will be in cloak near the center. Also, I have artillery cover going down, but I don't think it will be going off. He has no line of sight of his targets. There is smoke going down on this Comet, however. Oh, this could be very bad. Sniper's moving toward the center. However, the Fallschirmjäger don't actually spot him. Sniper's cloaking in cover. And Sniper's going to run across the open. May lose him here. We'll barely make it back to base. A lot of infantry trying to move in center. Squad is suppressed. Artillery cover now going off. Smoke grenade has been launched. Center VP may not get decapped in time, however. 3 points. 2. We'll decap it at 2 points. However, both squads can immediately jump back onto the point. We need your strong defense to guard the point here. On the right-hand side, we have an anti-tank gun sitting on the point along with the Vickers. Our Talisman has a ton of resources to use. Look at his manpower and fuel income compared to Primes at the moment. Totally covered, going off on this building, only causing minor damage. Infantry support gun knocked out 3 Tommies there. They're very bunched up there. ISG has 8 kills, 1 point of veterancy. Someone needs to move on to this point. Our Comet's getting repaired very slowly, Howard. There's only 2 sappers working on that. And what's even worse, now we have the King Tiger on the field. Volks are trying to move on to the center as well. Sniper does take a shot. Volks squad will be forced to pull back. ISG continuing the bomb. Our King Tiger is on its way, moving up to the front. Not sure if Prime can hear. He might be able to hear it through the fog of war. King Tiger is pretty loud. However, we do have units moving on the right hand side, but for Fallschirmjäger. Vickers is trying to relocate. However, Prime looks like he's calling it GG at this point. Else he can't continue to fight this. And King Tiger will just make it onto the field a little before the game ends. Well, I'll say it once again. And but I felt that Prime, well, he didn't really make any aggressive push. He was too focused on fighting in the center and wasting his manpower there that he never made any real attempts to capture the left-hand side. And his right hand was constantly being harassed by the enemy. And I don't think his vehicle play was particularly best. He could have used his AEC and Cromwell a bit better to, well, protect his right-hand side by giving him more map control. And eventually, he made a push on the battlegroup headquarters. Mortar pit would probably have also been nice. Ice on this map, at least place it down around here and begin bombing all the buildings in the center and maybe eventually get right into the battlegroup headquarters. But anyways, that's all I have to say for now, and this is Mirage Fla signing off.